Hey, what is going on, Intertubes? I'm Duke of the Bump, and this is Let's Play Popful Male Redux, episode number 5. We have Tat here. Oh, I thought he was nodding off, but he was just adjusting his hat. We're in a bit of a precarious position. We have 25 hit points, and male is not faring too much better. See what I mean about walking too fast? I barely had time to jump away from that snail. We are getting close to the town. I'm not 100% sure how close, but it can't be too much further. Aw, man. It was dangerous of me to come down here with so few hit points, but it is worth it because that chest contains an elixir, spelled with a Y instead of an I. That's how you know it's magical. Magical. Spelled M-A-J-I-C-K-A-L. The more it's misspelled, the more magic it is. That's the rule. Actually, come to think of it, is there such a thing as a non-magical elixir? Like, is there a scientific definition of the word elixir? These skeletons are a pain in the ass. You have to kill them twice. Like, I don't know. Let's switch to Tat. Well, I don't know. Male. As long as I don't jump too high. There we go. It seems like elixir is just an old... Oh, God. Is just an old-timey word that could mean any liquid. I don't know if there's an actual definition. Maybe it's like a suspension of some sort of particles in a liquid, or... Sweet. More gold bullion. More gold soup. That's a joke, by the way. I know the difference between bullion and bullion. Bullion. The soup is spelled B-O-U-L-L-I-O-N. I wasn't sure that was entirely clear in my previous video. I know my delivery can be a little bit deadpan, so I'm not sure if... Oh god. That jellyfish will zap me if I swim under it. However, since we fell, we're going to need it to get up to where we need to go. So, gotta just be patient. Let the jellyfish do its thing. There we go. And there should be the village right over here, I believe. Hopefully. Yes! Gaul Village. Monster is not welcome. Hopefully that does not include me. Whoa. Those mice do not look happy or healthy. Another one just chilling next to all his dead buddies. That's kind of morbid. No personal names, just Gaul. It's hell when you're being paged. Yes. There's a timely reference. Alright, items. Let's go ahead and heal. We have quite a bit of money to spend here. We have the dagger. Ooh, chainmail and round shield. Don't mind if I do. Doll? Missy? Do you know who I am?
What else you want to do?
Well...
You look like the picture of health.
Ugh, creepy. Alright, let's equip your stuff. Oops, item, not status.
Yeah, there we go.
And go ahead and sell that. Go ahead and sell the short sword too. We don't need that anymore. I should have sold it already. Leather mail, yes. And wood shield. There we go. Actually, I can sell some of that bullion, too. I have 2 of them. That's 1,000 gold. That's a lot of gold. Alright, switch over to Tat. Get you taken care of.
Hey, dig that red cape.
Bud. Damn it. What you got for me? Dino cane. I think that's... Yeah, I have a fire cane. I will buy that. For 300 gold. I was going to say I'd buy that for a dollar, but... It's not a dollar, it's 300 gold. Yeah. We have two elixirs, two apples. We're doing pretty good. This is what the dino cane does. It's not as good as I thought. I thought the dino cane had a beam that could be directed, but I guess that's the next weapon. Oh well, no matter. It still does more damage than what we had, so it was worth it. So a fire cane, so... I don't have armor to sell, do I? Nope. Just the stuff I just bought. Alright, sweet. What do you have to say? Well, gee. Tell me how you really feel. Roly-poly fish heads? Ugh. I just threw up in my mouth. Hey, fruit. Well, thank you. Yeah, apples. We have two. Let's stock up on a few more. I don't think I can afford 10, but I'll buy a couple. The amulet, I'm not sure if I said this before. I think it makes you temporarily invincible, but it makes it so you can't attack while it's in effect, which is why it says at what cost. Okay, we have 5 apples. That should be enough for now. Sometimes when you talk to people, they have more than one piece of dialogue. I should have been doing that this whole time. Nope, same thing. Oh, come on. I don't want the fish. I just want to go see what's down there. I'm not a pescatarian. I'm a Episcopalian. They're two very different words that sound slightly similar. Why does everyone always make that mistake? Okay. Well, nothing more we can do in the Gaul Village. But we are healed up. We are rocking and rolling on items. Let's go exploring. Oh god. Oh yeah, that's the special thing that this cane does. The shots actually go through the enemies. I don't think the previous cane did that. Which could be useful, I guess. You don't usually have more than one enemy lined up in a row like that. Boy, these enemies are kind of ill-prepared to deal with any kind of projectile attack. I should have gone up here instead of going to the right. Alright, the layout of this area can get a little bit tricky. Let me see if I can remember what I have to do. Pretty sure I have to keep going up until I hit a bridge. Oh god. Until I hit a spitting dragon head. Okay, I can jump up there. Maybe I can jump over to the right, and then keep it. No, doesn't look like it. Oh, there, made it. Sweet. Let's see. I think I'm on the right track. If not, then we're bound to have a big adventure either way. Or get ourselves horribly killed. I'm pretty sure I have to drop down here and head right. Yeah, there we go.
Hello? Is anyone there? Please help me! Monsters push me down the You sound like a god creature. Can't you fly back up the shaft?
It's too narrow, and I can't fly that high. Besides, two friends are trapped here with me. Boney Rubbler is holding them captive. Please bring help. We're scared.
Frankly, I'm amazed those wings could support its weight at all. Anything else you have to say?
Oh my, it certainly is a long way down there. Don't worry, I'll go for help.
Well, that's it. Just a reminder. And an invisible wall. Okay, well, let's head back to Gaul Village. They didn't take too kindly to me, but let's see if they are willing to let me help their friend. If I do that, I might be able to get into their good graces. Maybe get a little bit of information about the location of a certain muttonhead. Maybe get a little fish guts on the side. I don't know. I'm open-minded. I mean, hey, if it's as delicious as they say. I don't want none of those mice, though. That does not look appetizing in the least.
What? They've been trapped? But that's impossible!
But I'm afraid it is true. He fell in a hole so deep, he can't fly out. He says monsters did it to him, and that there are others trapped down there as well. Someone should rescue them.
I'm sure I could get them out if I was there, but I can't leave the village now because we're guarding against monsters! Say, you're a magician, and by the looks of it, most powerful.
Well, thank you.
Can't you help?
That's very kind of you, but you see, I am still in training. I believe that that problem is beyond my present abilities.
But at least you can try! Oh, you must try to help us!
I'll see what I can manage, but I'll make no promises. Do you have any rope by chance?
Do I have any rope? Does sulfur stink? I have a sturdy ladder made of rope and wood. Very, very strong!
I just hope it's strong enough to do the job.
Alright, I guess I have to get a ladder from this chest that appeared instead of just giving it to me, like it did the bombs. Let's see. Making pretty good time. Don't know if we'll hit a boss in this episode. We might. That Boney Rubbler fellow sounds like it might be coming up pretty soon. There might be some stuff down in that water, but honestly, I don't want to have to deal with the spikes and the enemies down there when I have a nice 100% health. I don't want to push my luck, you know? That elixir I went after, I knew it was there from previous exploration, but I don't know. In general, In general, the game gives you enough to survive. I mean, it gives you plenty of money to buy. Oh. Kind of bothers me that they spell Boney B-O-N-E-Y. It should just be B-O-N-Y. That's kind of a dumb nitpick to have the. But that's always bothered me for some reason. Whoa. Okay. Well, Hi. See if I can remember the strategy to beating this guy. If I remember correctly, it is a fairly simple fight. I say as I get hit for 40% of my health. But the horse part doesn't actually do anything to you. The only way you get hurt is if you actually let him slash you with that thing, as I just did twice. Did I save? I might have gotten overconfident. I don't remember if I saved or not. Nope. Great. Okay, well, won't take me too long to get back down there. I can't believe I lost a Boney Rubbler. I mean, come on, his name's not even spelled right. How do you misspell your own name? That would be like me spelling Duke, D-O-O-K. Which would be pretty unfortunate, come to think of it. Some people, and I'm not going to name any names in case they're watching, but they know who they are, have taken to calling me the affectionate nickname, Dookie.
Oh, you have no idea how good.
And I don't really think that's that affectionate. Damn it, I should have talked to him as male instead of Pat. At least have a different bit of dialogue. So yeah, always a duke, never a dookie. That's the message I have for anyone who might be watching. Alright, let's do this smart for once. What a concept. I'm not sure what a reveler is either, come to think of it. Is that his name or is that what he is? I'm not even hitting him, am I? Still 100. Is he immune to this weapon or something? Let's try switching to male. Nope. Maybe I just have to wait until he separates from his horse. I don't know. I don't remember having a problem with this guy. Maybe I have to hit him in the back? That's what it looks like. Ow. Yep, can't hit him from the front, it looks like. That's gonna make this more difficult. Great. I mean, you think, since I just got this weapon that fires piercing shots, they should be able to pierce through whatever is allowing him to block. But apparently that's not the case. I mean, I guess he's blocking with his lance thing there, but... okay, this is going a little bit better. Oh! Crap. I need to remember to jump over that. I'm using an actual Genesis controller, by the way. Aw, man! Which makes it more of an authentic experience. Although I never actually played this game on the Sega CD. Only in emulators. I had a Sega CD. But I didn't hear about this game until years later. And it's pretty uncommon, so I doubt I would have seen it in any game stores or anything. Interesting bit of trivia about this game. At one point, Sega was going to have... Falcom, I think, is the company that made this. They were going to have Falcom basically turn this game into a Sonic game. And it was going to, I believe it was going to be called Sister Sonic. and they decided to just localize the game and release it as is instead, which I think was smart of them. Because, I don't know, I can't see this as being a Sonic game. That would have been pretty bizarre. Oops. Let's switch players up now that I'm, now that I have them down a little bit. I wish that when you switch characters, it, refilled, or I wish it had separate ammo meters. Nope. Still have to wait for it to refill. I mean, if I can kill this guy, the town is just right over there, so I don't have to worry about damage or anything. I'm going to eat an apple, just to be on the safe side. I still have a pretty good stockpile of money, so shouldn't be too much of a problem. Man, this music's kind of terrible, though. Oh god. This is some experimental freestyle. I don't even know what. Oh, I can't even jump over him like that? I guess I have to run. Damn it. Alright, well, I'm getting there. Let's start out with Mail. She seems a little bit more useful for this fight. Just because her speed is an asset here instead of a liability. Great. Oh my god, this boss is so easy. Why am I having so much trouble? I'm sorry, guys. When I was practicing this, it did not take me nearly as many attempts as it is now. I'll try to, as soon as he's slightly off the screen, you can no longer hit him with your projectile. It's kind of a bummer. And this music is not helping my mood either. Sounds like someone trying to do terrible surf rock with an FM synth. And it does not work. You know what you know what game has some great music that I recently discovered on the Genesis? Is Streets of Rage 3. I played the original Streets of Rage game, and I didn't have much fondness for it. I'm not a fan of beat 'em ups in general, and everyone talked about how great the music in Streets of Rage 2 was, and I listened to it and I was like, yeah, this is okay. But then I listened to a podcast recently where they were talking about the best Genesis games of all time, the Insert Credit podcast, which is really great if you want to look it up, and they mentioned Streets of Rage 3 and how it is the best, sorry, I have an itch on my nose, if you were wondering. And they were talking about how great the soundtrack in Streets of Rage 3 was. And I went to look it up, and goddamn, they were not kidding. That is one hell of a soundtrack. Goddamn, I saw that was coming, I couldn't do anything to stop it. They described it as the electronic music of the future. And that's really what it sounds like. All the kids who are listening to dubstep now, in 5 years, the music they're going to be listening to will sound just like the Streets of Rage soundtrack. Their quote, not mine. Okay, well, an itchy nose and this music is making this fight go a lot worse. Now, when I was practicing, I didn't have the music because I was listening to podcasts while I played. Maybe that's the X factor here. Maybe I need to turn my volume down. Obviously, I can't listen to a podcast because I'm recording an LP. But if I fail this time, then I'll try turning down the volume and see if that helps. Because this music is seriously not improving my mood. This game does have some good music. I really like that. Seriously? I can't outrun that. I can't jump over him. What the hell am I supposed to do? Okay. Load. Volume down. Of course, the volume's still up for you, which I apologize for. Oops. Yeah. I do not know why I'm having so much trouble this time. I guess I just need to start popping more apples. I hate to do that, though. I hate to brute force my way through the boss like that, since this guy is not that hard. Maybe I just got him in a good pattern like this last time. They didn't attack. Of course, I shouldn't jinx it because I know if I say that, then he'll attack. Oh my god. He didn't even attack that time, I just jumped right into him. Oh great, and he still had his lance out. And I jump right into his lance. At least he always starts out heading right. So I can always get hit in on him early. There we go. This seems like a good pattern. I seem to have confused him. Come on, Boney Rubbler. Keep it up. This'll work sooner or later. There we go. Wow. Sorry guys, I did not mean for that to take so much time. Boney Rubbler destroyed. Looks like turning the music down was the key to defeating him. Hey, got a prison key. Wow, that's convenient. What does this prison key open? I would guess some kind of prison.
Oh. We were beginning to think we'd be in here forever. Oh, thank you.
Oh, it was nothing. Are you okay?
Yeah, we're all fine now. Come on down to our village and we'll thank you proper.
What kind of accent was that? Sounded like they were trying to do a southern accent, but it was completely mangled. I don't know what that was. It's not like male's Midwestern accent. That sounds genuine. I don't know what kind of accent they were trying for there. Oh god. I forgot we have to make it past some monsters before we are back at Gaul Village. Let's head back there and see what our reward is, and then we'll call it a video. I mean, it's already a video. You can already call it that, but, I mean, we'll end the video there. Wow, that guy's stoked. And he's not even the one getting rewarded. Must be pretty boring down here.
No harm done. I'm just glad to see you're all safe. Say, do you know the way to the other side of these caves?
Know the way? Gah. Of course God knows the way. You must enter the big door in the Cave of Wind. We keep the door locked always, but the key's in our treasure house. Take. Gah.
Well, if it's as easy as that, I'll be there in no time. Thank you for the information.
Yes, remember the sign that says Hot Springs? That's where we have to head at this point. See, now you're not concerned about me taking the fish. What the hell? All I have to do is spend a dozen tries to kill a skeleton dude. Life is like a box of fish. If you hang around too long, it starts to stink. That's pretty good. Pretty good, Gaul.
Take these for getting us out of that fix a while back. Take them. Go on. Take them.
Thank you. Thank you. It sounds almost like a robot southern accent. Like the voice is all modulated and weird. I don't know. It's still a pretty bad accent, even without the modulation. Alright. Alright. Yeah. I mean, that's good. We need that to progress in the game, but, you know, it's not sellable for 500 gold pieces. Alright, and that'll pretty much do it. Tune in on Friday for episode 6 of Let's Play Popful Male Redux. I'm Duke of the Bump, and I will see you guys next time.